Coming up, we'll take a look at SQL Server on Linux. I'll show you how you can download and install SQL Server on a Linux virtual machine, run your SQL Server-based apps inside of Docker containers, and improve the performance of your applications with Column Store, one of the many powerful features in SQL Server. In March of this year, we announced that we are bringing SQL Server to Linux. Today, we're announcing that SQL Server on Linux is available in public preview. The first thing I want to show you is how easy it is to download and install on Linux in under 60 seconds. Here on my MacBook, I'm running a Red Hat Enterprise Linux VM. To kick off the installation, I run yum install ms SQL Server. While that's installing, I'd like to tell you a little bit more about SQL Server on Linux. The scope of the first SQL Server release on Linux is the relational database only. Most of the key features of SQL Server 2016 will be included, such as transparent data encryption, always encrypted, row-level security, in-memory tables, column store, and more. Looks like the installation completed, so now you can see that we can install SQL Server on Linux in under a minute. That's how easy it is to get installed on your own VM, but you can also just grab a Docker image with SQL Server pre-installed. Let's take a look at an example of a Docker-based application with SQL Server container. Let's first look at the application architecture. First, we have a voting application, which is a Python-based application that registers a user's vote for either dogs or cats. The vote is stored in the Redis cache DB, and then a Java worker app container moves the vote from the Redis cache DB to the SQL Server database, and then a node-based application displays the results to the user. Now let's go back and Docker compose up our application. Now that the application is up, we can bring up the voting application and the results. Let's go ahead and vote for dogs, and that'll register the vote in the database, and we can see the results. Now let's take a look inside of the database and see what's happening. To do that, I'll run a command in the command palette to connect to a SQL Server database. I've already pre-cached a connection to my votes database running in my SQL Server container. We can see that we're now connected down here in the lower right-hand corner, and we can begin executing queries. So here we can see that we have a vote for dogs, which is B, and we can update the vote to A, and see that the vote has now changed from dogs to cats. So you can see that from this very basic example that SQL Server operates just like any other SQL Server, even when it runs inside of a Docker container. Now, let me finish up by showing you one of the many powerful capabilities of SQL Server. Column Store stores data on disk and in memory in a special order for fast access and better compression rates. I'll run this simple Java application, and while it's running, I'll explain what it does. First, it connects to SQL Server. Then it drops a database if it already exists and recreates a new empty database for us to insert data into. Then it has a simple data generation routine which inserts data into a products table and has a price column that stores the price of objects. In this case, we're inserting 5 million rows worth of data. After the data is inserted, we'll run a typical select sum query to sum up the price of all of the 5 million rows. Then we'll create the clustered column store index to improve performance, and we'll rerun the query to see the improvement in performance. So at this point, we're inserting the 5 million rows into the table. Now that the data has been inserted, we can see that the first query took 382 milliseconds to run. And now we'll add a clustered column store index to the table to improve performance. After the clustered column store index is added, the query time is only 7 milliseconds. So we can see that we got 50 times better performance just on my MacBook and with only 5 million rows. All I had to do was run a one-line T-SQL query to add the index. The best part is that we just announced that all the programmability features previously available in Enterprise Edition are now available in all editions of SQL Server, both on Linux and on SQL Server 2016 SP1 on Windows, which we also just released today. Hopefully this gives you a quick idea of how seamlessly SQL Server fits into Linux and Docker. It's SQL Server as you know it today, it's just native to Linux. It works with your data and your favorite tools, application frameworks, and programming languages. It's even easy to get, so go grab the public preview at the link below. We're looking forward to hearing your feedback and answering your questions over on Stack Overflow. Thanks for watching.